This is She Creates Business, a podcast for wedding pros. Your host, Kinsey Roberts, interviews incredible women in the wedding industry who are making their mark and creating success on their terms. Join the conversation.
Well, hey there and happy Tuesday. Welcome to episode 63 of She Creates Business, a podcast for wedding pros. This is, in fact, your host, Kinsey Roberts, and thanks so much for being here. As always, this show is literally not possible without you listening, so I really appreciate it. Today is the beginning of a new series that I'm going to do this summer. I thought it would be fun on Tuesdays. I'm going to call it something like Tip Tuesday, you know, something lame alliteration like that, because I love alliterations. Hello, nerd reader. And I thought it would be great just on Tuesdays if we could have a really quick tip where I share with you what I am experimenting with in my own wedding business for VistaView events in kind of the spirit of keeping an open dialogue, just to say what's working, what's not working, what am I trying, and I hope you enjoy it. So today's tip is all about how I picked the wedding directories that I have paid for VistaView events and what I am actually not paying for. And so let's just jump right into it. So I'll just tell you right off the bat, the wedding directories I am not paying for are like big wedding directories, like The Knot, Wedding Wire, anything like that, that is just so generalized, I have decided not to pay for. Number one, it's really expensive. For me, I think it is, even if, you know, this is our first year booking weddings, and while we're doing well, we already have weddings on the books for 2018, and I'm really pleased with our progress, it's still expensive, you know, $3,000-$6,000 a year to just get your name in a directory that's so general is not worth it to me. So let me start off by saying those are the kind of directories I'm not paying for, and I've also not heard amazing experiences with them. And so from other wedding professionals, you know, whether it be with reviews or what have you, I've heard that it can be kind of stinky. So I'm choosing not to pay for those directories this year. And here's how I did choose my directories. So when I say general, I mean, and you know what I'm saying, when you go on The Knot, when you go on Wedding Wire, you know, when you go on those huge wedding websites, it's basically like, here's you and 10,000 other vendors in your state. It's hard to navigate. It's not easily discernible where people should start. So if you're a venue owner like I am, or a planner or what have you, it's kind of hard to say, okay, where do I start? Like, who do I want to start with? Because there's such a big list here. And so what I've decided to do was, okay, my main goal is to find my ideal client, right? And not that everyone is going to be an ideal client, but that's my main goal. My main goal is to find my ideal couple. And my ideal couple is somebody who loves rustic glam, someone who likes rustic formal, someone who has a decent budget, because we don't charge, you know, $500 for our venue. We charge a lot more than that. And someone who is interested in a wedding barn, because it is a barn at the end of the day, but someone who appreciates customization. It's a completely blank slate, so they appreciate customization and they have ideas for wedding decor. Or they are like, I'm super happy that I don't have to try to cover up this blue hotel carpet because your venue is just completely blank inside. It's industrial chic. We love it. Great. So those are kind of the people that I was thinking of. So that was step one, my ideal client. Step two is, what are the keywords that I'm targeting? What are the keywords I'm targeting on my website? What are the keywords I'm targeting when I pin to Pinterest that are attracting my ideal client that I figured out in step one? What are the keywords that I have figured out would be good for us to target in Google Keyword Planner? I use Google Keyword Planner. And more than just my keyword, so I'm not just going to try to go after rustic glam, that's too broad. What are my long tail keywords, right? So mountain wedding venues in Colorado, wedding barns in Colorado, that's us, right? So I figured out what those keywords were, and then I searched them using a incognito window. So I do a lot of searching, so I didn't want to use my traditional Chrome browser, because it would just bring up what it thinks I want to see. So I got into an incognito window, so everything is blank in the background, right? And I did a keyword search. I did a search for those keywords in Google. So Colorado wedding barn in Colorado, rustic glam weddings in Colorado, because that's our location. And I figured out which wedding directories were coming up on the first page. I don't want to compete with them because they're wedding directories who are getting millions of visitors a month or hundreds of thousands of visitors a month. So I don't want to compete with them. I want to join forces with them. If they're on page one, then I am interested in paying for their directory. And so the first one that I found on in almost all of the searches that I did for my ideal long tail keywords was rustic wedding chic. It's at rusticweddingchic.com. It's been around for quite a few years. She gets over 1 million visitors per month, and the wedding directory I thought was really affordable. It's only $99 a month. You don't have any contracts with them, so you can cancel at any time. And there were very few venues in Colorado specifically that were paying for a premium listing, which is $99 a month. Anyone can have a free listing on that site, but if you pay for the premium listing, you're at the top and you get rotated in and out to be number one. And there's only four or five of us who are paying for a premium listing. So to me, I was like, okay, they are coming up for every single one of my keywords on page one, like in position three, which is amazing. And they don't have that many people taking advantage of the premium listing. So I will always be seen first. So I chose to pay for that listing and I'm doing it right now. And you guys, I am getting anywhere between like 6 and 10 hits on my website just from that one listing, that one listing every 3 to 4 days. That's great, right? So in less than a week, I'm getting like 6 to 10 visitors from that listing. And what's happening is that listing is going directly to my wedding page where I have an opt-in for our guide, and those people are opting in to that guide. So I'm growing my email list. Right now, like, we haven't had anyone convert from Rustic Wedding Chic. I think it's really important for me to be clear about that. I have not had anyone convert to a couple from Rustic Wedding Chic, but I am growing my email list from that, and I'm getting about 6 to 10 visitors every 3 to 4 days from that listing. And I'm really pleased with those results so far because I've only been doing it for, I think I'm on day 34, I believe. Let me check. 36. I'm on day 36. So I've only paid for it once so far. I'm pleased with those results. So that's how I'm looking for directories, you guys. I don't really think that the big directories are where it's at. I don't think our ideal clients are there. I think a lot of price shoppers are on those huge directories. And so if you are saying, listen, I do want to get the link juice, I do want to get that backlink juice, because backlink juice, SEO, it's still valuable. If you want to get that, I think, and you have, you know, some money to play with every month to submit to directories, maybe give it a shot. So I'll tell you my steps again. My first step is to really hone in on who my ideal client is. My second step is to figure out what keywords we were targeting. I already did that because I built my own website on Squarespace. So, and the tools I used for that were Pinterest, Google Keyword Planner, and just market research. I did a market survey in my area. And then finally, I figured out, so I did a search using those keywords in an incognito Chrome browser to see who was coming up on page one, and if any of those people coming up on page one of Google were wedding directories, and they were. And that's how I picked Rustic Wedding Chic. So give it a shot if you're interested in doing some directory stuff, but you don't want to have to spend, you know, thousands of dollars on directories that are only going to bring you a bunch of leads that are not qualified. Let me know what you think of that. Let me know if you totally ditch directories in general. That does it for this first Tip Tuesday for our summer series. And can't wait to chat with you guys. Shoot me an email at Kinsey@SheCreatesBusinessPodcast for any feedback or questions. Hope you have a great rest of your week, and I will see you back here on Thursday.
Thank you so much for listening to She Creates Business. Please take a minute and head to iTunes to leave an honest review so we can help more wedding pros find the show.